Welcome back to Monmouth in Focus. I'm Cynthia Scott. We are here at Biotech High School in Freehold Township. It is Organization Day, and joining me right now is Freeholder Lillian Berry. Freeholder, always a pleasure to have you and talk to you here on Monmouth in Focus.
Well, the pleasure is all mine, Cynthia. I guess this is going to be my seventh year on the Freeholder Board, and it's very exciting, probably as exciting as it was 6 years ago when I first took office. We've seen a lot of changes, we've had a lot of challenges, and a lot of accomplishments, and I'm very happy to say I was a part of a good number of them.
7 years, wow. When you look back, what would you say your biggest accomplishments have been?
Well, biggest accomplishments, I would say, have been that I have served on the Fort Monmouth Revitalization Authority. First, it started as an economic redevelopment authority appointed by the governor. And that, of course, was when Fort Monmouth was to close. And it was a very depressing moment, to say the least, to finally accept the fact that this formidable part of our county would no longer be. And I've served on that authority for 5 years. Now we've transitioned into the implementation of the plan that was evolved during that period of time. And I've been reappointed to the authority. So I consider it a challenge, yes, somewhat of an accomplishment because we've gotten this far with it, but I would say it's probably the single most important thing that has happened to this county, and so few people fully realize the impact. The impact could be very positive in that we are developing an entirely new community, but it's also a very sorrowful one because we've lost a very important part of our history.
Absolutely.
Here with Fort Monmouth. So that I would put my focus on Fort Monmouth.
Absolutely.
And then with the fort comes the veterans, and that we can't forget this. They're such an integral part of what the fort was, and of course, now we have our new veterans, those that are coming back from Afghanistan and have come back from Iraq, and we can't forget them either. So I'm very involved with a new program, which is called Soldier On. And it is intended to focus on the homeless veterans, or the soon-to-be homeless veterans. And it's an all-encompassing program, which 70% of it is funded by the VA. And the remaining monies, I am confident I can get from private enterprise people coming in supporting the whole concept. It's happened in Massachusetts. It's been extremely successful. And to me, it's just a perfect fit for Fort Monmouth.
Lots of great work there, Freeholder. Yeah. And what are you looking forward to in 2012? I know we have a tough economy to deal with out there, huh?
Yes, we do. And I think that's part of the challenge, is that we've been able to continue the services that our citizens expect from us. And yet we've held the line on taxes, on expenditures. In fact, we've even reduced our expenditures. We've reduced our workforce by attrition and other methods. And as a result, we still keep our AAA bond rating, which even our federal government hasn't been successful at that.
Right.
So that's something to look at with great pride.
All right.
And it shows that we are a very stable form of government here in Monmouth County, and one that I think we can all be very proud of.
Absolutely. Freeholder, thanks so much for joining us. Always a pleasure.
It's my pleasure. Thank you.
And as we all know, Freeholder Rob Clifton is moving on to the Assembly. I had the chance to sit down with him before his move to talk about his role as Freeholder. Freeholder, a bittersweet moment here on Monmouth in Focus. You know, glad that you're moving on, but sad to see you go. The past 7 years, you've done a great job as Freeholder and Deputy Director and Freeholder Director. Tell us what you feel most proud of.
Well, you know, it is bittersweet. I love working here in Freehold and the stuff we have done. I'm really proud about the way that Monmouth County has dealt with the economic downturn in the United States. Our staff has been absolutely unbelievable in going through the budget, finding ways to save money without having to have the layoffs that we hear about in the private sector. you know, our employment's down since I joined, but it's through retirements and attrition. It's county employees taking on more responsibility. And that's what I'm really proud about, the way they have rallied together as a organization to deal with the problems that we've had, the economic problems, but knowing full well that they're here for one reason, and that's for the residents of Monmouth County to make their lives better and to serve them, and they've done it outstanding.
Aside from the economic challenges, what has also been somewhat of a challenge, you know, the past couple of years?
Well, you know, I think that when I came in and we had gone through a little bit of an issue with some arrests of county employees and some negative news stories about the way county was being run. And what we've done is, I think, in the way we go out to bid, the way we do business in general, has turned in a very positive way. I think we're more open. We're more inclusive of a government. And the freeholders really realized that there were changes. We implemented ethics reforms. We implemented pay to play. I think we've been on the cutting edge of a lot of good, positive, good government type policies that are going to serve the taxpayers well.
Mm-hmm. Friola, you started out on the local level, then moved to the county, and now you're moving to the state level. You know, how have you seen these roles change?
Well, I can tell you, you know, being a small town mayor, things didn't always move as fast as you'd like them to. And when I came to the county, I was amazed at the speed in which we could get things done. Whether it was asking a staffer for information, how fast we could get it, or doing a project, fixing a bridge, fixing a road, changing our IT system, how fast and how professional the 2,900 employees here in Monmouth County and how well they work and just their attitude and knowing that they have to be efficient with county taxpayer dollars, but also make sure that they can get those projects done in a timely, efficient manner. And that's what I'm going to miss the most, is the people here.
Mm-hmm. And moving on to the assembly, what do you foresee?
Well, you know, we've got a lot of challenges at the state level. Obviously, the economy is the most important thing. We have to spur on economic growth. We have to bring businesses to New Jersey, and that's going to help everyone. But I want to continue to work with the municipalities here in Monmouth County and with the county government, as well as the municipalities I'm going to represent in Ocean, in Burlington, and Middlesex County.
Right.
It's a big challenge. There's a lot of work that needs to be done, but I think we've proven here at the county level that we can make cuts, still provide a great level of service and spur on economic development. And I think we can do it at the state level as well.
And let us know the entire district that you will be covering as assemblyman.
Well, in Middlesex County, it's Old Bridge. In Monmouth County, it's seven municipalities: Allentown, Roosevelt, Mattawan, Manalapan, Millstone, Upper Freehold, and Englishtown. And in Ocean County, it's Jackson and Plumstead. And in Burlington County, it's North Hanover, New Hanover, Chesterfield, and Wrightstown.
Okay, big district there.
Absolutely. Yeah. And it's got a unique character to it, except for Old Bridge and Mattawan. It's a very large horse racing and horse industry area. And that's going to be a focus. It's been a focus of my running mate, Ron Dancer, for many years, is the equine industry. But the equine industry in Monmouth County, as well as that section of our district in Burlington and Ocean, is very important and it needs to be dealt with. It's a multi-billion dollar industry.
All right, Freeholder, thanks so much for joining us. Best of luck in the future. You are going to be missed here.
Well, thank you. I'm going to miss everybody here.